Don't Come on and bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. We thank God for the Spirit of Christ. Amen. For being out in this house one more time and again. I don't know about you, but once again, I'm back again looking for a miracle. I don't know what you came to do, and I don't know what you're looking for on this morning. But I can stop by this morning to look for God to move in my life. I need a miracle today. I toiled real hard this week, and I'm looking for God to move to do something awesome on this morning. And I'm looking for God to deliver on today. Truly, we give honor to the Spirit of Christ. We give honor to the angel of this house. Our esteemed pastor, come on and bless him. Oh, you can do better than that. Come on and bless the Lord for the angel of this house. Amen. We give honor to the officials, to our chairman, our deacon Brett, and to the diaconette team, and all of our leaders in their respectable places, to our motherboard, to our first lady who stands by our pastor. Amen. Come on and bless her. Amen. Amen. It's good to see so many out. It's good to have our Deacon Johnson. Amen. 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 I thought I saw Mother Wilder walking. Amen. 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 Good to have our Mother Wilder. Amen. And to our Reverend Brick. Amen. It's good to have our Reverend Brick. And we want to welcome all those at faithfulnetwork.net. Thank you for visiting with us at this time. Let us pray. Father, we come now to say thank you. Thank you for grace and mercy. Thank you for this opportunity to be out in your house one more time, Lord God. We thank you for those who are lifting up the songs of Zion this morning, Lord God. We ask that you bless them one more time, Lord God. You was with us at the 8 o'clock service, Lord God. Now we ask that you give us a double portion now at the 11 o'clock hour. Be with us now. Come into the house, Lord God. Then bless the one that's going to break bread this afternoon, Lord God. Bless him in a mighty way, Lord God. Give him a word, Lord God, a word that looses and break chains, Lord God. And then, Lord God, allow someone coming to come running down the aisle, asking, what must they do to be saved? In the name of Jesus, we pray and let the children of God say, amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to have our congregation for him, led by my brother.
Instructions of a father and attend to no understanding. For I give you good doctrine. Forsake ye not my law. For I was my father's son, tender and only beloved in the sight of my mother. He taught me also and said unto me, let thy heart retain my words. Keep my commandments. Get wisdom, get understanding. Forget it not, neither decline from the words of my mouth. Forsake her not, and she shall preserve thee. Love her, and she shall keep thee. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. Verse 23rd, talking about this Holy Bible. Keep thy word.
God a hand clap of praise. If you really know that Jesus will bless the Lord, bless him. Bless him.
Thank you, Brother Rob, for being a gracious MC. We thank the kitchen committee, This is for application deadline is June 24th. So if you are interested in becoming a New York City bus driver, please see me. I have applications, or you can go to the MTA website and get the information for yourself. Members, relatives, and friends who are sick, hospitalized, asking for prayer and needing encouragement. Sister Cherise Lewis and her children who were in a car accident, some suffered serious injuries and some are still in the hospital. We're praying for them. Ms. Kim Bowman's brother-in-law, Malcolm Bowman, we're praying for him. Brother Shivers, that is Deacon Agnes Shivers' brother, he is having surgery soon. Sister Samantha Lennon, as well as her aunt. Sister Louise Newton's son is having surgery. We're praying for Sister Mitchell, Sister Betty Graves, Sister Juanita Sanders, Brother Troy Jeffries and son and children, Brother and Sister Roger. We know their son was in an ICU last week, but she testified this past week that he was talking and doing well. So we thank God for that. We pray for Sister Starry Flowers, Sister Mary McFadden, Sister Vivian Brown, Ms. Curly Crawford, Sister Brother Daryl Thompson, who had surgery last week, Sister Alberta Alston, Brother Wilbur Miller, who is still in the hospital, Sister Sarah Coleman, Sister Kiwana Jarvis, the Pollock family. Thank God again we have Deacon Johnson with us in the house today. Brother Gus McCormick, I know he spent the day with his daughter yesterday. Amen. So thank you God for that. And we are happy to have Brother Jamal Warren. You know, he went away to pay his family's taxes. Amen. Thank you God for that. We're praying for those outside of our church. We're praying for the shooter in Las Vegas who executed two policemen, as well as some others in front of Walmart. We're praying for the school shooting that took place this past week in Portland, Oregon. If you listen to the news, they have said that 74 shootings have taken place in schools since the Newtown Elementary shooting back in December. We are praying for the loss of activist Ruby D. We pray for her. Pray for her family as well. Thank heaven for you, to Pastor Crawford and my church family. Thank you for your prayers, phone calls, visits, and cards. They helped to assist my recovery. God is the healer. With love, Deacon Samuel and Lily Johnson and family. Thank you for all the fathers, Lord, who teach us how to live, who reflect the love and faithfulness that you alone can give. To all fathers, saying a prayer that God will fill your day with happiness and fill your world with blessings, the diaconate ministry. Best wishes to the grads, to the UGMBC grads of 2014, and going to the next grade students. We are proud of your achievements. May your future hold fulfillment and well-deserved success. Congratulations, the Pastor Frederick and Lady Antoinette Crawford. Happy Father's Day to Union Grove dads, fathers, and father figures. We are proud of you all, great men of God. Love the Women of Excellence Ministry. On Father's Day, if the fish aren't biting, hope you catch yourself a snooze. Happy Father's Day. To our pastor, Frederick Crawford, love the New York Missionary Baptist Church, Women of Excellence Ministry. Amen. Happy birthday to all who celebrate a birthday. May you please stand so we wish you a happy birthday. Breadwinners, the life givers, the head of the table, the head of the house, the teacher, the preacher, the friend, the psychologist, the psychiatrist, the Y chromosome, the prayer warriors, the remote controllers, the protector, the provider, the butcher, the baker, the candlestick maker, the diaper changer, the lawnmower, the rule maker, the rule breaker, the biggest piece of chicken meat, the daughter's first boyfriend, the heroes, the overwhelmed, the unappreciated, the hardworking, the single, the proud, the wannabe, the deadbeats, the inspires. Happy Father's Day.
Amen. We greet you this morning, the only name that matters, the name of Jesus. And to our worship leader, our minister Lionels, all of our ministers, to our leading lady Crawford, to our deacon ministry, our mother ministry, to all of you, my father children, it is certainly good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen. I want to wish all of our fathers, those who played a role as a father, a happy Father's Day. Amen. Amen. Congratulate you on today. Certainly want to wish you a happy Father's Day. And to those mothers who played mother and father, amen. I want to congratulate you. Amen. Congratulate you on today. Let me take a few moments to thank those who went with us on last Sunday to the Central Baptist Church as they celebrated their 95th church anniversary. We had a wonderful time there. We had a good time in the service as well. And Pastor Butler certainly enjoyed our coming there on last week. It was an hour and some change drive. But we thank you for coming and sharing with us on last Sunday. I know that you made his heart glad, and you certainly made my heart glad just the same. And then we thank those who was able to come out on Monday. We had a meeting here Monday. We thank all of you who came out on Monday. We had a great time here on Monday. We thank you so much for your labor of love and coming out and being concerned about your church family. And then on Wednesday night, as we continue our Bible study, we certainly want to thank our Deacon Irene Pollock, who have been teaching for 3 consecutive weeks. Amen. And I know that she's done an outstanding job. And those of you who are not here, you missed, amen, this woman of God who's able to expound the Word of God. But on this past Wednesday, we was inspired by the Holy Spirit, those that were there to fast this week. And we want to thank those who are fasting even now, today. And we are laboring over personal concerns for people. We exchange our concerns. And so we're not just praying about ourselves, but we're actually praying for some other concerns. And so we thank those who have committed themselves since last Thursday. We conclude on this coming Wednesday. And if there's others who have asked us, are we going to continue? We don't know. Just show up on Wednesday, amen, and be a part of what God is doing. And then the Whosoever Will Ministry was having their relationship conference, and it was phenomenal. We was there, amen, to support him and also support Pastor Sean Atkins at the Antioch Baptist Church, and we had a great time there. And we know that those who went, you were tremendously blessed. My brothers and sisters, as I look around the audience, I see that God is still in the healing business. Amen. 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 I look around and I see that God is still in the healing business. We ought to be excited about that. Amen. Our Deacon Johnson, we're glad to see him back. Amen. Amen. Brother McCormick. Amen. Glad to see you back. Amen. Our Brother Brick. Amen. Moving about. Amen. Giving God a praise. Amen. Amen. Brother Wilder. Amen. Back with us today. You know we're pleading in our sacred here today. Amen. Amen. Even our nurse Waters. Amen. We're grateful to God for him today. And then I look at the Rogers family. Amen. And know that God is in the healing. Amen. Healing heaven. Several Collins is back there. Her daughter's back here. She's sitting over there. Amen. I see you over there. Amen. Amen. So we know that God is in the healing business. And if you came today to get healed, you're in the right place. Amen. 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 You're in the right place today. Amen. We are grateful to God for the healing that's going on in this place. And we're grateful. I can't call all the names of our visitors, but I'm grateful for all the visitors who are with us today and those who are watching through live, not favornetwork.net. We thank you so much for tuning in with us on today. And we're just blessed here at Union Grove. God is doing such a great thing here at the church right here. And on this coming Friday, we have our pulpit aid ministries. I think of Pollock and his ministry will be doing a platform service. Our sister Celine, amen. Minister Trainer will be speaking. Also, our Deacon Michelle Crawford will be speaking. And those two names alone, you ought to come out, amen, and support them. We're going to have other ministers here. But we're going to have a great time on this coming Friday. We look forward to you coming and sharing with us. All of our deacons, we need to see you immediately after service. It is a meeting of importance. All deacons, we need to see you immediately after service. Now, those of you who are going with us to Delaware on June 29th, we are encouraging those of you who are going to please see our brother Kenny Brown. Kenny Brown will give us a stand so they know who you are. Amen. Our brother Kenny Brown, if you're going with us, we appreciate that you will give him your name. We are trying to make proper provision for all of our members to travel there. We are hoping that we do not have to use any of our vehicles, that we can get on the bus and go there. Our first bus is already pretty much filled. We want to know whether or not we need a second bus. So we need you to, if you're going, please see her. We're going to Deacon Michelle Crawford's mother's church. This will be her mother's first opportunity and chance to serve as a chairperson for the missionary anniversary. We certainly don't want to disappoint her. Amen. As we go and support them. So if you plan on going, amen, please see Brother Kenny Brown. Even if you were thinking about driving, see him anywhere. If any way possible, please let us work together. Amen. And let God bless us. Also, our Brother Kenny Brown will be in charge on June 24th. If we have anybody here that's unable to go to the polling site because of transportation, our Brother Kenny Brown is here. We are making our van available for those that cannot get to the polling site. We want every possible person to be able to get to the polling site on June 24th. And so we have made our van available. See him so that we can take you to the poll and bring you back home. And also it will give him a chance to coordinate how he will go around picking up people on that day. And if you cannot go because of your health, you cannot get on the van, you cannot get on the bus, or cannot get in the car, we will have someone here that will be able to do absentee ballot, but we need to know in advance so that we can get your vote. Every vote count. Amen. Every vote count. So we would like to establish that if you cannot get to the polling site, we will have absentee ballot available for you. Amen. Now, next Sunday will be our last opportunity for I Love My Church campaign. We want to thank God for those who gave to the campaign. Those of you that was not able to do the full amount, we are praying that you will do something on next week. Whatever it is, whatever amount you can give to the Lord, it will be a blessing to this ministry. Amen. We have done some tremendous things in this ministry. God has certainly blessed us, and we are doing some great things. And we need your support. We need your continued support. And so all of you, my brothers and sisters, receive, take an envelope today. I'll pray over it this week and bring it back on next Sunday. We know that God is going to show up mightily on next week as you give and show your love to this church. Amen. We have done an outstanding job in being a witness for the Lord by wearing our buttons, by talking about I Love Our Church, by posting on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. You'd be surprised what God has done, amen, on social media because of you. And we are absolutely proud of what God is doing and what God can do even now. So we want to encourage you to continue doing your support as you have been doing. My brothers and sisters, after morning service, the women of this church is going to give all the fathers, amen, first dibs at getting a piece of cake, amen. They have some cakes for all fathers, amen. And so you can go downstairs and get a slice of cake, amen, enjoy it on behalf of our women, amen, of the church. And those of you that missed out on yesterday, amen, we want to congratulate our scholarship ministry. They did an outstanding job. And those that was in the cook in the kitchen, they cooked a wonderful meal. I wish they had brought it back again today, but unfortunately, most of us ate it up on yesterday. Amen. Amen. But it was a great meal, and we thank them so much for the labor of love. We want to thank our Sister Roundtree, our Sister Karen Two-Time, and those that work behind the scenes, their committee, those in the kitchen. It was a great turnout. We want to thank our Deacon Michelle Crawford, who invited an individual who came and spoke and encouraged not only you, but everyone who was present on yesterday. And it was, again, it was a great turnout. We want to thank those that gave their pledges, and we're still looking for you, those that can, to give a donation toward our scholarship ministry. We are excited about what we're doing for our college grad and even our high school grad, our elementary grad, our junior high school. We're encouraging them to further their education. And so we thank the scholarship committee for what you're doing to encourage our young people, amen, here at Union Grove Missionary Baptist Church. And also, I want to remind those of you who are going to the youth conference, we need your deposit, we need your down payment now so that we can make, again, preparation for you. That happens the first weekend in August, and we need those who are going to the youth conference, we need you to see our Deacon Reed or one of our youth leaders as soon as possible so that we can make proper preparation for you to go there and back. And also, the same thing applies for the trip to our church picnic. We have our Sister Rachel Smith and our Sister Dinkins, and we have our Sister Florence Green, who are taking up a collection for, amen, our picnic. And if you need to see them, please do so. We also ask that you will give your deposit. My brothers and sisters, we are excited about every one of you being here on today. We thank God for you. We do not take this lightly. We thank God for you. And I want you right now to just shake somebody's hand next to you. Just tell them you're glad to see them today. Amen. And we're glad to see Minister McFadden's brother here today. Amen. Glad to have him with us. Amen. Today, and all of our visitors here today, we thank God for you today. Let's give our youth and young adults a hand. Amen. They were the youth this morning at 8 o'clock, and they are regular students at this time. Amen. At this time, we're going to lift our tithes and offering. We want to encourage you at this time to please, my brothers and sisters, whatever you have to give to the Lord, we ask that you will put it in an envelope. Amen. Even if you visit with us, we encourage you, all visitors, we encourage you to also do the same. Put it in the envelope at this time. Amen. At the appropriate time, all of our tithes and offering will be sent to the center aisle, and the deacons and trustees will come and they will collect it. Amen. Just before you give, amen, just before you give, we're going to use, amen, the giver's confession as our prayer today. Amen. It's printed on your envelope. Amen. Our giver's confession on our envelope, we're going to use that as our prayer today. Amen. And so does everyone have an envelope at this time? Those of you who are watching us through Favor Network, you can also contribute. There's a button called donation there. You can give a donation. If you've been blessed by this ministry, and I know you have, please feel free to donate to this great ministry. God is doing some great things here at the church. Is there anyone that needs an envelope here at this time? We want to encourage all of you to please take one, and then let us all read the giver's confession. Let us all stand as we read. Okay. Amen. And those of you who have out of my church offering, please put it in my hand that I may pray over it before we give it to the trustees. Amen. Amen.
God bless you, my brothers and sisters. You are joining us live here at the Union Grove Missionary Baptist Church, where great things are happening. At this time, we are taking our offering. I'm excited that you have joined us this morning for worship, and God is doing some great things here at our sanctuary and in our service. And I would like for you to be a part of this ministry. I would like for you to sow into this ministry. God has blessed us. We are doing some great things, some powerful things. We are changing lives. We are changing communities. And we are about to do some outreach ministry, going over the world, do some ministry. But it takes your help. It takes your support. And I know that you can't be here, but we thank God for you watching us. And if you want to be a blessing to this ministry, we would like for you to press that button that says donate. You can give us your tithes, your offering, and certainly it will bless this house. And in return, God will bless you. Then 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, it talks about how God expects us to be a blessing to the church, how we are supposed to give the first part of our income. And when you do so, God loves a generous giver, and he will give it back to you in so many ways. So many people look for it to come back one way. But God, when he starts blessing, he blesses us in so many ways. And so I want to encourage you, my brothers and sisters, to sow into this ministry. Again, we are doing some great things. We are building a new housing development. We are giving supplies to our children, school supplies to our children. We are feeding the community. Last year, we fed over 800 persons. This year, we look to do more than that. We are taking kids to a church picnic sponsored by the church. My brothers and sisters, we are doing some great things. We're getting in now to do some tutoring, some after-school programs, and we need your support. And again, we're taking up an offering right now at Union Grove, and the people are being blessed by doing so. And I want you to be blessed. I want you to be a part of what God is doing. I've learned a long time ago in my studies that when God is blessing the house, you want to sow into that ministry, because as he blessed that house, he'll bless you as well. So again, I want to encourage you. There's a donate button. It's very secured. We have a secure process. You can swipe your card. You can put in your credit card number or debit card number, and it will come through. And we will certainly let you know that we received it. God bless you. We love you. Again, it's offering time. You cannot be God-given no matter how hard you try.
Oh, To be free.
Amen. Amen. There's nothing wrong with giving God praise. My brothers and my sisters, there's nothing wrong with giving God praise. Especially on today. Because Jesus told us that when we pray, we ought to say, "Our Father." And today is Father's Day. And we ought to tell God, "Happy Father's Day." Is that right? Because God has been a father to us and a mother to us. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Thank God, thank God, thank God. Amen. Let those that want to praise Him, praise Him. Amen. Sometimes we worry about those that's praising Him. We ought to be worrying about those that's sitting still. Amen. Amen. We ought to give them a boost or something. Amen. 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 These individuals, what Peter was trying to tell the folks, amen, on the day of Pentecost, they're not drunk as you suppose. Amen. I know you used to folks carrying on like this when they had a little something to drink. But this crew didn't have nothing to drink. They got something on the inside of them. Amen. That makes them feel this way. Mother Steve used to say, what is this that makes me feel this way? Come on here, somebody. Amen. Amen. They're not drunk like you think. Amen. They got something else inside of them. Amen. Thank God for that Holy Ghost power that makes them look like they're drunk. Amen. We ought to thank God for that. Amen. They feel good this morning and didn't need nothing to make them feel that way but the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. That's all right. That's all right. Amen. That's all right. Amen. Let the Lord have His way. I know we're rushing and trying to get here, there, there, where. Listen, Red Lobster steak still going to be there. That fish still going to be there. That lobster feast still going to be there. That captain's, you know what their names are. Still going to be there. Amen. Amen. Now, you know, unlike Mother's Day, it's not going to be as crowded. So it'll be room when you get there. Amen. 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 When we have this time, we ought to spend some time with the Lord. Amen. Amen. Ought to spend some time with the Lord. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Again, we thank God for the young adults. Amen. God has blessed them. And thank God for Brother Kevin. Let the Lord use him. Amen. Amen. I know that I'm supposed to be preaching a three-part series. Amen. But I feel good. Amen. I know you came to hear me preach about the man of steel. Amen. But the Lord is moving right now. Amen. The Lord is moving right now. Amen. Amen. That's all right. That's all right. God is working something out in her life right now. Can I tell you that God is working things out right now in her life? Amen. And you ought to be celebrating that God is working things out right now. Right now, God is working things out. Right now. Yes, Lord. 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 Amen. My brothers and sisters. The anointing of God is in here. I want to say that again. The anointing of God is in here. And I've been preaching long enough and been dealing with God long enough to know that when God shows up, whatever I have planned moves to the side. I want to say that again. I've lived and preached long enough to know that when God shows up, whatever I have planned moves to the side. Why? Because God is trying to do something. And I see Him in our midst this morning. I feel His presence here this morning. Even in my own body, I feel God moving. I feel so much better now. Amen. Minister Connor said, but you want me to get Mother Gertrude to pray for you? I said, no, just wait. Because I knew God was going to show up. Didn't know how He was going to show up. But let me tell you something, God is in the building. Now, let me be clear on this. God always shows up. But sometimes His train fills the temple. Amen. Let me say that again. God always shows up. But there are times when His train filled the temple. And when you read Chronicles, you'll find that the priest could not minister when God showed up in that fashion. The smoke was so overwhelming that they didn't even do their duty, could perform their duties, because the presence of God was in the place. And my brothers and sisters, I feel that anointing in this place right now. Because I feel that strong anointing, I don't know who's here that's got an emergency problem. Somebody here today got an emergency problem. They said, listen, I can't wait next week. Something is going on right now. If you're here, I want you to come forward. If you got an emergency situation, I want you to come right now. I don't know who you are, but come right now. And I want you to stand that middle aisle. Amen. If you got an emergency situation, amen. I know. I feel the anointing in this place. And I'm not going to let God leave this building without me doing what he assigned me to do. Series, but I got to do what the Lord told me to do. Amen. I've got to be obedient. And if you want that anointing, it'll come through the screen right now. This place is filled with His presence, and I command that it go through the television. I command it go through the internet and touch you wherever you are. Put your hand on that computer right now. Put your hand on that iPhone and feel the power of God in this place right now. And join us next week as we will start the three-part series on the man of steel. But I need to oil right now, and those that want it,